Visuals aren't everything when it comes to video games, but sometimes developers set the bar a bit too high when they first reveal their latest passion projects. A few games looked so good that you could swear that they were in development for the next generation of gaming, never mind the PS4 and Xbox One. Things changed though, as these games slowly lost their visual fidelity closer to the launch of the game. Things started to look a bit more dull, and although some of them still looked great, they did look better before. FACTFEED presents Worst Game Graphic Downgrades from Trailer to Release. Watch Dogs. When Watch Dogs was first unveiled back in 2012, the game looked awesome, but there was this next-gen look to it that hinted that the game was in development for the next generation of hardware. It had this advanced graphics feel to it that made use of some intense textures, lighting effects, and cloth animations on Aiden. When the game was first revealed for PS4 and Xbox One, it made sense. The only issue we had here was the game went from looking like something out of the future to looking like a port PS3 port on the PS4. Dull world, uninspired visuals, and an overall downgrade from the initial footage of the game. It was not like the Watch Dogs we were introduced to. Killzone 2. E3 2005 was a big event for Sony. The Japanese giant announced their successor to the PlayStation 2, and among the several trailers they showcased for the conference, one piece of footage was pure bliss and unbelievable. Killzone 2 was revealed and it created a massive amount of confusion whether this was real time or CG. Later on, it was revealed that it was a CG trailer, but Sony initially misled players by claiming that this trailer was using in-game assets. I remember Phil Harrison claiming in an interview that this was not CG, and everything that the player saw was in-engine. The final game was not even close to the E3 gameplay trailer. Red Steel. Developed exclusively for the Nintendo Wii, Red Steel is a first-person shooter by Ubisoft. Throughout the game, players use the Nintendo Motion Control Wii Remote and Nunchuck attachment to crush enemies with a katana and firearm. The game showed real promise during different media events, such as E3, but once it was released, the game seemed to receive mixed reviews. The game looked nowhere near as good as the footage released by the development team. To add salt to wounds, the game also suffered from several bugs and glitches. Star Ocean 4: The Last Hope. Star Ocean 4: The Last Hope is an action RPG that takes place in a time where the world is at its brink of destruction. Set in the year of 2064, World War III has already started leaving massive armies clashing between one another throughout different land masses on Earth. Shortly after the war ends, most of the human population, along with Earth's resources, have been destroyed, leaving a squad to locate a suitable planet for mankind to relocate. Overall, the game received positive reviews and looked decent, but there was a downgrade from when Square Enix first showed off Ocean Star 4: The Last Hope. Some of the character models and environments featured decreased details. Dark Souls 2. Anyone who had played the past installments knew that Dark Souls 2 would be painstakingly difficult. Back in April 2013, a video was released showcasing a new Dark Souls 2 gameplay demonstration with fantastic lighting effects, post-processing effects, and high-resolution textures. But once the game launched, almost every graphical effect from the previous build was absent. In fact, the video game looked drastically different, to the point where it looked like it belonged to a previous console generation. Some of the software developers came out and stated that the development process for any video game is constantly being balanced for playability, resulting into a difference in the visuals. Regardless of the statement, it was a massive graphics downgrade nevertheless. Final Fantasy 13. Final Fantasy XIII was in development for a few years, and during this time period, it went through various gameplay and visual changes. From the initial reveal trailer to the launch trailer, you can see drastic differences in the game's overall look and feel. Many blame this on the port to Xbox 360, in which Square Enix had to heavily reduce the game's graphic details to fit onto the console. The game was a PS3 exclusive at first, and was revealed to be an Xbox 360 title too, a year before launch. We can see various changes in visuals, as well as the main protagonist of the game getting tweaked too. Lightning's face changed drastically from the initial reveal to the launch trailer. The game still looked great at launch, but it looked better initially. Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six Siege. Oh, Ubisoft. What are we going to do with you? While games like Assassin's Creed Unity and Far Cry 4 didn't get bumped down as much as other titles, one cannot ignore the drastic changes that come with Ubisoft's games. One of the most memorable ones from recent years has to be Rainbow Six Siege. In the reveal trailer, we see a game that has identity. Its nighttime scenes are dark, with lamps in the distance impacting the area all around it. Water on the guns as rain falls down from the sky, and flashlights being vital to the game's overall lighting effects. What we got in the final game was something else. The game had a global light that eliminated the overall dark look and feel to the game. This also eliminated the feeling you got when playing in day and night. It resulted in a washed-out experience with dull colors and poor lighting effects. The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. The Witcher 3 might be one of the greatest games of this generation, but its initial reveal footage looked stunning, and better than the already flawless final game. The final version of The Witcher had a much lighter tone to it, with a brighter color palette. The initial reveal was darker and looked stunning. The game is the only game on this list to actually hold up as a great final release, as although it was heavily downgraded, it still looked fantastic. It was not until late in the game's release that CD Projekt Red, the guys behind the masterpiece, released a patch for the game that enhanced the game's visuals to a new standard. Cities were much more vibrant, and draw distance was enhanced. Still, it did not beat the initial showcase, but it was a great effort. Forza Motorsport 5. How badly can you downgrade a racing game? Well, Microsoft proved that anything is possible. Sure, its release model was up to standard, but you don't see the major differences in the game until you put the two copies side to side. Everything from the foliage to the spectators saw a massive downgrade in visuals. Car paint was less impressive, spectators were cardboard cutouts instead of 3D models, and the lighting system saw an all-around drop in fidelity. It was a benchmark game that looked great for its time, but it's very different from the Forza 5 that we saw in the first place. Aliens, Colonial Marines. Fans of the original Aliens trilogy were undoubtedly waiting for the launch of Aliens, Colonial Marines. The game took place 17 weeks after the events of Alien 3, where the cryotubes containing Ellen Ripley, Corporal Hicks, Newt, and the android Bishop are ejected from Sulaco. Gearbox showcased a terrifying atmosphere with aliens that could track you down easily, and to top it off, the game looked rather spectacular. With the game launched, it was a totally different product compared to what Gearbox had been showing in the past. The game essentially sucked in all departments. Sega later on admitted that the game was falsely represented through various demos, but also blamed Gearbox Software for showing demos as final game representation. Halo 2. After their massive success with Halo Combat Evolved, Bungie brought out the direct sequel, Halo 2. The video game follows up with Master Chief and Arbiter as they take out the parasite army known as the Flood. Halo 2 was shown off at E3, and it was clear that the title would hold some massive graphical upgrades compared to the previous Halo installment. However, that changed upon release. When Halo 2 launched on November 9th, 2004, players were surprised with the downgraded graphics compared to what they saw during E3. Regardless of the graphical changes, Halo 2 went on to become a massive hit, just like its predecessor, leading Bungie to develop Halo 3 for the Xbox 360. Far Cry 4. Far Cry 4 is an open-world first-person shooter. Players take up the role of AJ Gale, a young Karate American who is returning to Karat in order to spread his mother's ashes. However, AJ finds that the country is ruled by a tyrannical king, leaving him pinned against the king's oppressive rule. Far Cry 4 was shown off at several media events and looked great, and even after its initial release of the game, still looks fantastic. However, if you compare the E3 demonstration with the retail version, you can see that there are a few downgrades. The foliage density and the level of detail and lighting seem to be a bit below what players were shown before.